Hey everybody, it's Black Cat Patterson back at you again, doing a little brown fishing, going to go play some hooky. I wasn't planning on going today. Last night when I went to sleep, about 10 o'clock, it was 90 degrees. It's been in the hundreds all week, but I woke up this morning, it's 75 degrees. And weatherman says it's not going to rain, but I don't know, it looks like it. The wind's blowing, so we know a cold front's coming through, which they did predict a cold front was coming through, and it's supposed to be, I think the high today is 86, so it's cooling off. I mean, it's hard to say 86 is cooling off, but I'm not a meteorologist, I don't understand that, but I do know what it looks like, and that's a rain-looking sky right there. So anyway, we headed to Jack's Creek, one of my little favorite spots. I'm gonna try a few things. All I have today is I got about 10 grubs. I got a bucket of Kelly's red worms. I like to send a shot to Mr. Kelly out on 261. Hope his health is holding up. Send a shot to my buddy Johnny. Johnny will be going fishing on next Wednesday. So put that on your calendar next Wednesday. I am off. We are going fishing. Rain, snow, sleet, or shine. You're a Marine, if it's lightning, you can hide under a tree where you're not supposed to. But we are going fishing next Wednesday, Johnny Durant, aka Fall Guy, I'm sorry. So, also I want to send a shout out to Island Marines for these nice optics. These are some transition readers, and I can see up close, I can see far, I can see glare. Mr. Allen, I can't say your last name, Mr. Allen, I'm sorry. Made these for me at Allen Optics, so hit me up for their contact information. These are nice tortoise shells, very nice. So today, I guess because of the wind, there's not a lot of people fishing today. And a boat just left out of here, and he's probably going the same spot I'm going. So the entire lake, we only got one boat. It looks like a pretty big boat. So that might not be, he might not be brown fishing. Hey everybody, I think I told you. Temperature changed today. It's the first day probably in months it's been this cool. It's about 76, 75, 76 degrees right now. Wind's blowing. Coming kind of from the north. And trying to spot, hadn't been in a while. I'm using these Mach 2s, I'm using a grub, fishing about 4 foot deep. I got some worms also. Try to sneak in here on these fish and see if they're still in here. So normally they're in here. But we'll see what happens today. Take a red worm. Him in the middle. Oh yeah, I see him hitting the water back here. Like a real big one, but fish probably 3 foot deep. Trying to cast it under the trees. Big one. But he's a fish. So that's your lucky fish. First fish of the day, you don't put him back. He's not supposed to. Let's cast back over there and see if there's something else bigger. I'm gonna try to position the boat and anchor it. The wind's kind of blowing me. I'm not fishing exactly where I want to fish. Move this boat a little bit. This one here is sitting on the bottom. On a tree stump is what it is. Ooh, I think I broke that one. I sure did. Broke it good. Put a little heavier lid and stuff on the stopper. Same size stopper. I'm gonna leave that stopper on there. How do you tie your hook? Some people tie just knots. When I say knots, I mean they just go loop to loop. I like to turn mine in and turn it back on itself about 7-8 times. Wet it. And pull it like that right there. Let's see. Wind is turning around, it's pushing me out to the end to the fishing spot now. Let me see if I can back out of here. I'm not too close to the fish. Because if that happens a lot of times, you scare them. Got just a little piece of worm hanging. Just cast it over here under the tree and see. Might be old fish in the fish, you never know. They go bite. Little fish. Little fish. But it was a bite. Usually it's a big old bite. It's a little fish. Usually if it's a big one, you'll know, because he'll take it and go with it. And that's fishing up next to the bank. You know it's a little fish over there. Not a big boy. This time of morning, they're usually out. There we go. A little better. So, this stuff is not acting all right. I'm gonna cut this tip off of it. Wind's blowing me. Don't want to go. It's right on top of the fish. Let me get the trolling motor working. Get the hook out of my shoe. Cold, I'm in. The wind has this swirling in here. So we might need to go to a spot that we don't have any wind. Fish the bank. Let's see if I can catch a big boy over here. Sitting in a hole in it. Like a shell cracker. Perfect. Tell you a funny thing about this spot. Probably about 40 years ago, my cousin and I were fishing and a storm came up. You could hear it in the background coming this way. And he said, come on, let's go. I said, nah. I said, I'm just hooked up. I don't have a fish. And I said, no. I said, it's going around us. He said, nah, man, that storm coming. I said, no, let's stay here. And we did. And the storm came and caught us. And we sat under some trees. And I mean, it rained like no get up and go. All right, y'all, we're in another spot. The other spot just wasn't paying off. You can go ahead and count to three. One, two, three. Ain't in there. Shake a little bit. One, two, three. Bunch of little ones today. Here's that same little piece of worm. Go to another spot. One, two, three. Shake it a little bit. Oh, wow, look at that. Bass back there. I know you can't see it. There's a bunch of bass back there. They're funny. Must be can see the tip of that hook. There's an alligator out here this morning. Nice and cool like this. All right, y'all, we're gonna try the 3-second rule. And my 3-second rule is I go 3 feet, 3 seconds in a spot. And if I don't catch a fish, I move it. So count one, two, three, move it. I went through right on top of a tree. I popped my line. So that was my 3-second rule, y'all. Some people spend a lot of time fixing reels. Best thing to do is just bring some extras. Because the time you spend fixing a reel, you could be catching fish. Unless you just really like your reel. And I really like that reel I had. It had a true turn hook on it and everything. So guess what? Well, maybe I'm going to have to kill. All right, so I threw it in the exact same spot, so I'm going to get hooked up again. There go the fish, though. Nope, I might not. So there's one over there. Hey, everybody. That cat Patterson coming back. Fishing a little fat worm. Fishing about 2 feet deep. Cast it back here. Let's see how long it takes. One, two, three. No bite. Shake it. And when I shake it, I pull it about that far. One, two, three. Shake it. And what I'm doing is I'm fishing the edge with a lot of debris. Poor fish. A lot of trees that's in the water. And a lot of trees in the water. Like the tops of them, I guess. And I'm just throwing in the area, letting it sit there for a few seconds and dragging it. You put it in there and you count to three. And you're gonna catch a bunch of little ones, trust me. But there's big ones in there too. Sometimes when they're bedding heavy, there's nothing in there but large ones. I don't know if they run the little ones out or what. But seems like today ought to be a good day. So this spot, okay, I threw it in there. Let's count to three. One, two, three. That was, must have been a, could be a mole mount in there too. Catch a lot of those mole mounts or war mounts, or I call them hybrid smallies. Go to another spot in there. Let's see. One, two, three. They in there. It's just a bunch of small ones. One, two, three. One, two, three. I'm about to get hooked up. Let's try the other side. That ain't gonna take long. There's little ones over there. It's gonna be little ones over there. Shake it a little bit. Count to three. Okay, maybe. Oh, there go one. Biting like a shell cracker. Got it. Try a different spot. And it is a baby. So we probably need to move up out of here because that's a baby. Try one more spot in here and see. I didn't try right here. Well, I did. I got hooked up and I didn't throw back over there. So let's try it in the open. I think something's, I don't know what that is. There ain't no fish. Oh, yeah, it is a fish. He's just little. Now you know you got skill and you can catch a bass that small. That takes skill. Oh, come on, get back. Come on, you gotta go back. Come on, you gotta go back. So my baby Anastasia can catch you when you get big. Look at that. That's a bass. Yeah. So it takes skill to catch a fish that small. Lots of skill. A lot of people feel bad when they catch small fish. But my theory is if you can catch the little ones, you can catch the big ones. So practice on the little ones. look at how they bite. And oh, I had a bite just now, y'all. He was sitting there holding it. Wasn't a big fish, but there it goes. I don't know what it might be, a turtle, I don't know. Nibble it and just sits there like a shell cracker, but they don't take it down, so. Probably some more, it might be a little school of them little bass over there. I'm gonna go back a little further and see if I can catch a big brown. Don't look like it today. Ooh, got to pull up anchor here in a second. Find some big fish. It's a little bite. So that's a little fish. You can barely take it. I'm gonna throw over here with Shane and Chris like the fish. Right in the hole. Oh man. That was quick. Oh, he got me hooked up. That was quick. He got me hooked up quick. Oh, I popped another line, y'all. Thank you.
Thank you.
sodomizing or something.
fat shell cracker.
All right, everybody, I'm going back to use my grubs. Got a spot on the point. Wind's blowing out of the east. Over here in this hole. See how long it takes to get a bite. Might take a while because fish ain't never seen no grubs. This one got a worm on it. We're gonna buy it. We'll buy it. I'm fishing too deep or too shallow. Hook showing maybe. Oh, yeah, that's a little fish. Little fish, you got it. You're taking it down. Something stole that grub, y'all. Something grub on it. Something definitely took it. Don't know, hit it one time. It'll be a mean fish. Hang out of that grub. Ooh, that grub bad. And I don't have on it. I'm in the boat just in time. So that might be why the fish shut down. No, catfish don't come in there.
fish hit it. No plan. And he just whopped it. So a lot of times you're in a brum area, you're gonna catch catfish. And when you start catching them on top of a bed, they'll leave that bed alone for a while. The brim will, they'll move off. Wait till that predator leaves. Sometimes they will sit there and you'll see them swirl in the water. They're fighting, trying to get them off of their bed. Let's throw another one out there and see what happens. So obviously we know they catfish like grubs. Let's see if we can catch another one. Oh, there it is. Oh, it was gone. On already, y'all. Something over there like them grubs. Try another one. A mealworm, I'm sorry, they're not grubs, they're mealworms. Man, I'm throwing against the wind, I can't hardly throw. Can't put it back where it was. Maybe I need to go in and fish out. I'm sitting out here in the wind. I think the wind done pulled my ankle loose or something. Wind swirled. There we go. That is, dang, look at that. That's a big old shellcracker. Wow, look at that shellcracker. Now that's a shellcracker. Catch a few more of those. Look at that. That's a shellcracker. One direction, then it'll stop, and it'll swirl another direction. It'll stop. Uh-huh. That catfish. Swirling us. White. He is biting like a little baby fish. popping it. I don't know though. You got the line tight. Ain't no little one. No, he definitely ain't little, y'all. Catfish. Ooh, that's another big shell cracker. Wow. Look at that shell cracker. Oh, that's a shell cracker. Gee, I wonder. He's swallowed it. Get the hook back out of him. I swallowed it and run with it a little too long. Gotcha. Sorry, I'll show you all that one. That was a big one. Get the hook. Getting the hook back. A little big fish though. Thank you. a catfish. Yep, it is. I ain't bringing no net. Come on back up. Come on back up. Come on. Oh boy. Wheel yourself out. Spin. Come on. That joker, I can't do nothing with it. Stay still. Stop fighting. Stop fighting. Stop fighting. Stop fighting. Stop fighting.